after we do our mash, we do the rest. We open up some valves and let the wort come out into the grant. Once we take all the wort into the grant, we put it into the kettle. We do a sparge process, part of the lautering process. We do our sparge. Once we're doing it, you know, cleaning the grain off, we're putting it into the kettle. Once we get it boiling, then that's where we're adding our hops at. And you know, we either, you know, we add the first hop, second hop, third hop, aroma, bittering, you know, flavor, whichever, you know, bittering in the first, flavor, aroma at the end, depending on how you're doing your beers. And then of course we use different hops, different alphas, which are, you know, of course, lower alphas will help make you a nice, smoother beer. Higher alphas can help make a more of a bitter beer. The hops that go in the end of the boil, the hoppier your beer will actually seem, but not necessarily in bitterness. So the end of, you know, a lot of people want a real hoppy IPA bitter beer. You know, you got different stages at different times you can throw those hops in. So it's just kind of a matter of how you want your beer to be bitter and your IBUs on that, which is an international bittering unit. So
what we get a chance to do in the boiling process is balance out the sweetness of those grains, you know, in that recipe when we had all those sugars. And so a hop process, you know, we do triple hop our beers, as do the majority of breweries. And, you know, each hop has its own quality. Some of the hops are for flavor. Some of the hops are for bitterness. Some of the hops are for conserving the beer. And some of it's for aroma. A lot of beers get the majority of their aroma from that hop at the end, so because hops are very aromatic, and what they do is they add flavor and the smell of the beer. You know, the big companies spend a lot of money growing specific hops so that you can smell what their beer smells like, and they want it to smell the same way because they market it to a much bigger audience. But we do the same thing. You know, we want a certain kind of hop in each beer that we do, and that's part of the recipe. But the boiling also does one thing: it takes out any impurities. You know, we had that grain that was in the ground, we mixed it with water, we cooked it. So once you get that to a boil, we're taking care of anything that might bother the yeast when we get to that where the magic happens section, when the yeast gets in there and make its alcohol. If we haven't removed any impurities, then we're gonna have trouble with our yeast. But that's what the boiling process takes care of. A lot of things. It takes care of cleaning the beer. It gives us an opportunity to balance it, the sweetness of the grain with some bitterness of the hops. And whatever recipe we want, whether we want it to be balanced more on the hop side, we get a chance to do it there. If we want to keep it a sweet beer, then we also have a chance to reduce or use a certain kind of lower alpha bittering hops in the boiling process. But that's how we utilize the boil, and that's what the boil really is for making beer for us.